If you know one thing about Bubble Sort, it's that it's a horrible sorting algorithm. It famously has a big O n squared time complexity. That is, if you want to sort n things, you need to make on the order of n squared comparisons, and that's not great. But Bubble Sort is great for one thing. Bubble Sort has one good use: beer tasting. As you surely know, there are two main goals when having a beer tasting. One, you want to have all the beers sorted from worst to best. And two, you want to have drunk all the beers. It's especially for goal two where algorithms like Quicksort or Heapsort won't cut it, as they are too efficient. The beers get sorted, but the beers don't get drunk. Two other nice properties with Bubble Sort is also that it sorts the beer in place, which means you won't need to move the beers all over the table and you'll have plenty of space for a snack bowl. And Bubble Sort is resilient to an unreliable comparison function. Say the comparison function starts becoming a bit too drunk and makes mistakes, or decides in the middle that it actually doesn't really like IPAs, then with Bubble Sort you still end up with a kind of sorted list of beers. So, if you don't remember exactly how Bubble Sort works, or you just want to learn the correct ordering of this selection of industrial lagers, here's the Bubble Sort algorithm applied to beer tasting. We'll start at the beginning of the list, comparing the two first beers. If we believe they are in the right order, with the best one to the right, we do nothing. However, that would make Budweiser the tastier beer, and yeah, that's not the case. As they are in the wrong order, we'll instead let Budweiser and Staropramen switch places. We'll then move one step and try the next pair. Thank God, this is a hard one, but I think today Pilsner Urquell will win out. So they are in the correct order and we do nothing, and move one step. And now we continue comparing, maybe switching, and moving a step all the way to the end of the list. At this point we've taken a pass through the whole list, and now we ask ourselves the question, did any of the beers switch places? If no, the list is sorted and there's nothing more to do. But lucky for us, we switched quite a lot, so we can keep on drinking, tasting beer. You also saw that Pilsner Urquell kind of bubbled to the top of the list. That's why it's called Bubble Sort. The top items will bubble to the top. It has nothing to do with the carbonation. This algorithm works well for wine tasting as well. Right, let's take another pass. And now Staropramen has bubbled to second place. One more pass. One more. Aha! So in this last pass we didn't make any switches, which means the beers are now sorted from worst to best. And as Bubble Sort is such an inefficient algorithm, the beers are now also mostly finished. That's why the one good use of Bubble Sort is beer tasting. Or wine tasting. Or, I guess, tea tasting should work for non-liquids as well. Maybe cheese tasting? I don't know.